All right, which do you think is softer, this light or this squishy pillow? What is up, people? Dunna here, and today we're gonna be taking a look at the Falconeyes SO28TD Edgelit LED panel. But I also wanna invite you to leave a comment below and let me know, what are you lighting your videos with? Let's start a conversation. Okay, let's break down the name of this and it'll give us a little bit more information. Falconeyes is just the brand name. SO stands for Sophies, which is the line of lights. 28 stands for 28 watts. And TD is for tungsten daylight, because this is a variable color temperature light. Now, I also called it an edgelit LED panel, and that's because of its special and unique design. First of all, notice that it's round. We don't normally see that in these kind of LED panels. Instead of having a flat panel with a pile of LED diodes facing forward, this light actually has 120 LEDs around the edge facing inwards and reflected forward through this plastic diffusion material. And I absolutely love this design for a couple of reasons. One of the problems with the LED lights that we're used to seeing, with anything from 9 diodes all the way up to 600 or more, is that each diode actually casts its own shadow because it's its own source of light. So for example, if I place an object in front of this light, you'll notice it casts multiple shadows. That's one coming from each diode on the actual LED panel. You'll also notice this as a problem when you try and use the barn doors on an LED panel to contain the light, because each one of the rows will actually cast its own shadow against the barn door. So instead of a nice even cut, you get all these different lines. Now typically, to battle this, we'll put a layer of diffusion in front of the light. Now it becomes one light source instead of multiple. But the problem with this is you need the space for the diffusion, and it takes time and effort to set up. The beauty of this design, where all the LEDs are pointing in and reflecting forward through a diffusion material, is that it's already one big light source by the time it's coming out of the panel. So basically, it acts like an LED panel that's been shot through diffusion material or a softbox, and it gives you that nice soft diffused light. This makes it so much easier to set up and use, and you don't have to carry around that much stuff with you. Another thing that makes this easy is just the size of it. It's super small and super light. And although it may not seem like it's much smaller than my other panels, remember that with these ones, I have to add a bunch of diffusion. So all of a sudden, my 1x1 foot LED panel becomes a bit of an endeavor. At first, I was actually a little bit worried about how small this panel was, because I wasn't sure that it was going to be big enough to give me a nice soft light. But if you've seen my video on basic lighting, you'll know that to get a soft light, we can either have a large light source or we can have it very close to the subject. And with the small footprint of this light, it's really easy to get it in nice and close, achieving that same soft look. If you haven't seen that video yet, I'll link it in the description. All that being said about the size of this, there are two larger versions, the SO48 and SO68, that I'm excited to try out at some point, but I've been really happy with the performance of this, and having the small footprint actually has its advantages. The build quality on this is great for what you pay for it. It's made of mostly metal. There's plastic on the back and just on the front diffusion panel. It's got a 1/4-20 tripod mount if you want it, and it also comes in this U-bracket that rotates 360 degrees, which makes it really easy to get it wherever you need it to be. On the back, there's a 3-way power switch, so you can choose between off in the middle, the supplied AC cable on the left-hand side, or the not supplied Sony NPF style battery on the right side. Having the Sony NPF batteries is great, and it actually only takes one, whereas a lot of LED panels need two. And the battery life on this thing is fantastic. I've run it at 100% for 2 hours with an NPF 970 battery, and it still had juice to spare. Beside the battery, we have the LCD touch display for info and for controls. Here you can choose your brightness between 0 and 100% in 1% increments, which is really nice since a lot of other LEDs move in bigger steps. This allows you to really dial in the amount of light that you need. Also, some other lights don't go right down to 1%, they'll stop at 5% or even 10%. Beside that, you can choose the color temperature from 3000 Kelvin to 5600 Kelvin without too much fluctuation in the output of light. I do wish that that range was a little bit wider, maybe even 2700 up to 6000, but this is still pretty good, and for most purposes, it's more than enough. According to the manufacturer, it has a CRI and TLCI rating of 95 plus, which means you're gonna have really nice color reproduction. And in the testing that I've done, I've been really happy with the quality. So who's this for and what can you use it for? Well, personally, I've actually been using it a lot lately as my key light. It's so easy to set up, and as long as I get it in close enough, I can actually get a nice soft light. Maybe one of the larger versions would do a better job, but I've still been really happy. But where I think this light really shines, pun intended, is for product photography and videography. One of my favorite things to do with this light is put it on a C-stand and throw it straight over top of a product facing straight down. The soft light that comes out of this thing is so nice and it just really highlights everything about the product. However, because of its shape and design, you're limited in how you can control the light. Basically, it's a big wide spread coming out of the front of this thing. Whereas on other panels, you'll have barn doors to shape the light. With this one, you're gonna either have to do some DIY stuff, or you're gonna have to have other stands with light modifiers. When I'm using this as a key light, I only ever turn it up to 50%. The light that I'm using right now, which is one of these, is actually at 100%, but by the time you put it through the diffusion, it loses so much of that power. All in all, coming in at 189 US or 249 Canadian, I would highly recommend this as an easy to use, affordable, and high quality LED panel for YouTubers, filmmakers, or photographers. Or it could be like an unnecessary but cool reading lamp. If you want more info or you're interested in purchasing this light, I'll leave a link in the description as well as links to all my other gear. If you had fun and you learned something, make sure to give this video a like. It really does help. And I'll see you next time.